Tennessee. Welcome to Victory Harbor. We're so glad you guys are here today. Today's sermon nugget is building bridges. Some time ago in Idaho, there was two brothers and they owned adjoining farms. And not only were they brothers, they were best friends. They were very, very close. Fact is, they shared farm equipment and every day they would visit each other. Sunday meals was always together and all the kids played together. The cousins always got along good. Everything was going great in their life, and then all of a sudden they got into politics. One of them was a Democrat and one of them was a Republican. And it started out with just a little bit of riding and a little bit of kidding, and then it got out of hand. One of them would call another one names, Snowflake, and the other one call another one something else. The next thing you knew, there was a war going on. It got to the point they wouldn't speak to each other. It got so heated, they wouldn't even let the kids play together anymore. There's no more coming over Sunday dinner. Everything was a disaster in their life because they let politics separate them. Well, Paul, who lived on one farm, decided that he was going to take the bulldozer and reroute the creek to make it run right between their property where his brother couldn't get over there anyway. So he did. Well, that really made John, the other brother, mad. So he didn't know what to do, but he is stewing on it, and all of a sudden he gets a knock on the door. There's a man there, he says, "I'm a carpenter. Have you got any small jobs I can do?" John said, "Have I got a job for you? There's a stack of lumber right there beside the barn. I want you to build me an 8-foot tall wall that separates me from my brother that lives in that farm over there. I can't stand to look at him. I don't want to see his face. I need you to build me that wall." The old carpenter looks at him, "I think I understand." So the next day he's getting ready to get started work, and John said, "I'm going to go to town. I won't be back to dark." Carpenter said, "I'll probably have the job done time you get back." So John left, and that carpenter got to working, and he worked and worked and he worked all day long. Built the prettiest bridge that you'd ever seen in your life. And that bridge went across that creek, attaching that property lines together. And it had pretty handrails on it. Everything was good. Time old John got home, he seen that supposed to be a wall and it was a bridge. He's mad as an old wet hen. Then he looked coming across the bridge. There Paul was coming, his brother. Had his hand stretched out. Said, I want to tell you how much I appreciate you building this bridge, especially after I've been so mean to you. Would you forgive me?" And they hugged each other and everything was going real good. And they got over their little mad and they decided one of them wasn't going to be a Republican, one of them wasn't going to be a Democrat, but they're going to be Americans. So they got in unity and they asked, John asked the bridge builder, or the builder who wanted to build the bridge, if he would hang around and do some more work. And that bridge builder said, "No, I've got a lot more bridges to build," and he left. We need to be building bridges, not tearing them down. We don't need to be building walls, we need to tear them down. Let's go to the Word of God today. We're going to the 5th chapter of Matthew, verse 9. "The peacemakers are blessed, for they will be called the sons of God." Why is there such lacking of peace in the world today? The first thing is, Satan is running rampant, and people are not wise. They can't see that these little things that we're letting separate us is really hindering us spiritually. Satan has been running rampant ever since the Garden of Eden. We need to get a hold of this. We need to learn to be peacemakers. There's too many people in the world today that are claiming to be warriors, even spiritual warriors, but really, they're not being peacemakers. They're stirring one side against the other all the time. And that's not of God. We need to learn to be at peace with our neighbor. The first thing to be a peacemaker you've got to learn to do, be at peace with God. To be at peace with God, first off, you've got to be in a relationship with Him. You've got to accept Him as your Savior. You've got to repent of your sins. Confess with your mouth that Jesus came in the flesh, died on the cross, and is coming back. He rose again. And then you need to be reading the Bible. You need to be communicating with God through prayer. Make peace with God. The next thing you need to do is make peace with yourself. look and realize if you got all this turmoil going on in your life, something's wrong and it ain't God. It's the devil stirring you up. The next thing you've got to do to be a peacemaker is those people that you've had a problem with, those people you've got trouble with, go and fix it. Tell them you're sorry. Get over this thing. Fix this. Heal this wound. You've got to learn to build bridges, not burn them. You've got to build them. But if you want to burn some, burn the wall. Get rid of that wall. Don't build them. Learn to trust God. The next thing to be a peacemaker you've got to learn to do is be a peacemaker between others. If you see it, John over here and Paul over here with contention, try to tone it down. Try to bring peace. Don't carry gossip. Don't spread rumors. Bring peace to them. Then you'll be a peacemaker. A peacemaker is not somebody that wants to kill the enemy off. Killing the enemy out don't solve anything. We need to work to solve disputes and problems. Jesus does not teach us to annihilate somebody that don't agree with us. He teaches us to love our enemies. Are we doing that? With God's peace in our heart, we can overcome this evil that's in the world today. But we need to shake it. We need to get beyond. I want to have it my way or die. We need to get beyond and we need to get to that point and be a peacemaker. Now there's a myth about peacemakers. Most people think peacemakers are weaklings. They're not. I'll assure you they're strong in the Lord. They're doing what God said. Don't consider them weaklings because somebody's wanting to make peace. Consider that a good thing. We've had too much division. We've had political division between political parties. It's running rampant in our country right now. It is destroying the very fiber of our country, the very nature of our country. Our country is not to be hating on each other. We've let racial division and separation and racism run rampant in our heart. That's not pleasing to God. You've got where the Methodists can't stand the Baptists can't stand the Methodists, the Pentecostal can't stand either one of them, all these other denominations. It's all about hate. We've got doctrinal differences. We need to get beyond that. Agree about what you can agree on. Quit finding fault with everybody. Quit building walls and start building bridges. That's what we've got to do in Jesus' name. Are you a wall builder? Are you building walls? Are you a bridge builder trying to bring peace? Please, please be a bridge builder. Let us pray. Father, I ask you to bring peace to this country. Lord, get rid of all this separation, all this hatred and bitterness, all this evil and negative feelings that we've got. I ask you to cast them out of our life. I ask you, God, to bring peace in all these situations. Let us get in unity because that's where the blessing comes from. When we're in unity, you bless, Lord. And I ask you to bless now. In Jesus' name, we thank you for being in our service. God bless you. See you next week.